train, and so you're going to learn a lot more about training, so we are very excited. All right, sir. Andre.
Hello, I'm your host, Andre, and this is the Andre Show. Last time, we talked about what we use gems for, and we had a mystery topic. Well, now it's time to reveal the mystery topic, and it's trains. Now let's get started. There are only two kinds of trains. They are passenger and freight trains. For example, monorails and mammoth trains are both passenger trains. Freight trains are usually diesel trains because diesel train engines are very powerful. Freight trains are called freight trains because freight means goods that are carried by trains, planes, trucks, or ships. Goods means objects that are sold or objects that someone owns. Freight trains are more powerful and not so fast because freight trains need to pull cargo, and some cargo can be heavier than passengers. Passenger trains use electric engines most of the time because they need speed, not power. Sometimes a passenger train may use a steam engine, like the train on Mount Washington. Most trains can't move without tracks. Tracks have two metal rails with wooden ties. Ties are wooden rectangles that go under the two metal rails. Ties are useful because ties help stabilize the two metal rails. Stabilize means to secure. Monorails use only one rail because of the way that they are built. The stem mono means one, so monorail means one rail. Electric trains have often a third rail or a cable above the train because it helps pick up electricity from the electric train. Monorails may be a type of electric train, but they do not have a third rail. Maglev trains are trains that don't need tracks because maglevs have magnetic levitation above the guideway. The guideway is a surface that guides the maglev train. Did you know that maglev trains go much faster than other trains because they are aerodynamic and magnetic levitation helps lower the friction? Aerodynamic means that a shape that doesn't cause air friction. Friction means an object or surface that moves against another object or surface. In this case, friction is not good because passenger trains are supposed to be fast. Friction can slow things down. In some cases, it is good, like when you are making a fire because friction causes heat. Sorry, but our time's up. Next time, we will talk.